Welcome to this brief guide on how to use live data in Excel. Working with a form of ever-changing data, such as country information or stock prices in Excel, can be quite time-consuming and arduous to constantly be updating. So today I'm going to show you a feature of Excel to make that a thing of the past. Here you can see I happen to have my mystical homework where I've got a list of all of the countries in the world. I've gone and gotten all this information from a particular website, and what I'm going to need for my homework is to find some information out about all of these particular countries. Now I could look at doing the research myself manually and then entering all that data into my next columns. However, I'm going to use the live data feature to get this information for me. So the first step will be to select all of the data in my table. And then we're going to head up to our ribbon and we're going to select the data tab. And then once we've selected the data tab, about a third of the way along, we can see that we have these images here with different forms of data. And hitting the drop-down arrow there, we can see some even more options, such as the options here available by default with stocks, currencies, and geography, as well as options for things such as animals, films, and even yoga poses. In this case, our data is geography. So what we're going to do is we're going to select this option, which is then going to convert these countries into actionable data for us. This is all powered by Bing. And right away, you can see that I now have this brand new little map icon next to the names of all of my different countries. This lets me know that Bing has been able to find this information. Selecting any of these icons will open up a quick little information card right there for me to be able to quickly view information such as populations, size of the country, GDP, or even their capital cities or major cities if they don't have a capital city. This is the information that I'm now going to use. So I simply select my table, and now I can see that I have this new insert data icon that appears for me. Selecting this is going to give me a massive list full of options available for me to select. So many different options for me to choose from, such as birth rates, currency codes, gasoline prices, GDP. I'm going to start with the capital city or major city. Selecting this will automatically create a new column for me and input all of that data. Now, what you might notice here is that all of these major cities also have their own map icon. That's because these are recognized by Bing as well and become future data points that I could utilize if I wish, such as being able to find out the population of individual cities. Now I'm going to add some more by going back to my first column for my countries, select my insert data option, and then we're going to go through and let's find what we can see here. We've got populations, official languages. Let's go for something like life expectancy. So now we've added in life expectancy for each of these different countries. And what you'll notice is I've got a bit of an error here. That means that there's no data currently available via Bing for this particular option. Now, this means that if I wanted to, though, I could go through and find that information separately, but what you'll notice is I only need to find a couple of them as opposed to going through and finding all of this information for all of the different countries around. Now, I'm not just limited to my homework. Now that I've finished my homework, let's go and have a look at some stock prices. Here you can see I have the stock codes for Microsoft, Google, Apple, Meta, and Datadog. And now that I've selected that data, I head to the Data tab in my ribbon, and select the option for stocks. And what this is going to do is it's going to convert these ticker symbols over to their full company name and their stock codes and let me know even that these are all on the NASDAQ stock exchange. I can also now click on the stocks icon, and just like I got with the country data, I will have an info card that will let me know that Datadog is based on the NASDAQ stock exchange and things like that. I also have the option for that insert data button just like we did with the countries. But now the options are going to be a bit different because this is obviously stock information and not country information. So I can select items such as the current price for these stocks, and I can see exactly how much each of these stocks is worth at this moment in time. I can add in another column as well, and so maybe let's add in something like each company's market cap. And now, this is going to be a big one for some of these companies. Wow, those are some big numbers. But I now have all of that information right there for me, ready to be able to utilize. However, these prices change quite often, sometimes down to the second. So what I need to do is find a way to keep my data up to date. In that data tab, just like we did before for getting our stocks, we can use the button that's found here that says refresh all. And once we choose to refresh our data, we'll see that our data is being refreshed via those icons there. And once we have our stock icon back there again, we'll know that our data has been fully updated right to this very moment in time. And that applies both on my stock information as well as on my country data. So if the life expectancy of any of these countries was to have changed in this period of time, it would be updated here as well. And that's how you use live data in Excel. I hope you found this tip extremely useful, and I'll catch you in my next video. Thanks for watching. If you'd like to see more content like this, be sure to check out the channel. And if you like what you see, don't forget to hit that subscribe button.